Welcome back to another episode of GSW Cybernetic Television. I'm the voice, Fidali, and once again, we're here for a laid-back episode of Cybernetic. And once again, I have a co-host, Eric Pinhat. Welcome to the show, buddy.
What's up, my brother?
First time in front of the camera for these things, right? Usually, like...
Yeah, I'm usually, like, way over here.
Way
like
back there.
You guys can see me. Hi.
He's good. Yeah, we're all here. And again, the feel of these shows is really simple. We're just trying to talk about our favorite matches at GSW, because... After May 13th, you might not have a promotion or a queue to do this with.
I mean, I'm being goofy and having fun, but the guy is right, you know. We all put a lot of time into this company, and it could be fun.
Yeah. And we have, I think, this episode, then one more episode, then the show will be happening on May 13th. And what we've been doing, Eric, I'm sure you've been watching, but we're just picking our favorite matches. You pick one, I pick one, and we'll let the fans just see that. So I'll go first. I'll let you think about yours a little bit.
Head-scratching.
We'll go... See, I've been doing this the past 2 weeks, so I'm kind of running low on favorite matches. Show 50. Yeah, it was. A six-man tag. I'm going to try to involve some people who are actually in our main event at Civil War on May 13th. On one end is the Cashmasters and Stevie Shields. The reuniting Young Hustle versus the team of The Takeover and Sean Silas. Yes, they are. Still are. Even though we kind of wish, you know, not joking, nothing but speedy recovery that meniscus tear. And I'm sure Adam Thompson will be back sooner or later.
Hopefully,
yeah. Yeah. So let's get to that. And also, guys, before we get into the match, before we wrap up the show tonight, I will have the last match to announce for Civil War.
The last match for Civil War.
Ding, dang. See you guys soon.
Ready? You see this face? Here's the face of someone who's ready.
All right.
The face box get
you ready. Got it. I got it.
Let's go!
Let's see.
Yeah.
Yeah, what a great match from 50. Excited to see all those guys like back together again, and then Mark Hart super kicking his faces off in that match.
Yeah, they look like they're having fun, man.
Which is what we're all about here.
Like the fundraisers.
See, that's what I'm talking about. We are all about fun here at GSW. We're all about.
I got my hat.
Oh, you can't win them all, buddy.
Eric, no pin hat.
And again, this is family fun. I've known Eric for almost 20 years now.
Something like, yeah, pretty close.
We've come up in this business through this whole valley, and GSW is our home.
You lit me on fire one time.
I'll find the footage, and I won't show it out here because it's graphic. But find me or Eric, we'll show you. It's awesome, actually. Not all. For me, it was awesome. For you, not so.
No,
anyway.
Don't ever get lit on fire, guys. It's not fun.
No, it's not. Actually, no. Like I said, we have a lot of fun here. It's very much a family atmosphere at GSW. And we're going to go into Phase 13 to fight to keep that family atmosphere. The closest that
I mean,
is.
Yeah, I can't.
Yeah, I can't.
You can't. But those guys that are going to be back there, they're going to come out here and they're going to do the thing like this.
We got five guys
who... Maybe some of these.
Let's get the tripod over.
That's pretty close.
You're nice. They said we have five guys in that match on the GSW side for fight for there. Guys who we... Train Mike Vaughn,
one of
the guys we know very well. Someone who's been nothing but a monster for us, Bruce Van Slyke. Someone who,
man,
my last match ever in a GSW ring was against Bruce Van Slyke, and he larried my face off. It was gross. Yeah. It's still there, man.
Can we hold the face off jokes, please?
Why did it? I'm sorry, buddy. The cash matches who we just saw, and of course, the Shields we just saw, who was one of our longest ring heavyweight champions here. We have a good mixture of guys. With that being said, Eric, I'm going to get on to our second match tonight, and that one's on you, buddy.
Oh, boy. I didn't have much time to do the head scratching, but I'm going to pick one that was very special to me. I want to be in there in the Civil War match and the cage match doing the thing, but I can't because there's a hole in here. So I'm going to pick what was my favorite match in GSW, and it was ended up being should have been my retirement match, but it's kind of back, against AJ Evers. Way back in August of 2015.
Yes.
And go ahead. Enjoy that match.
Have more time. That's Matt Delane. There it is, folks. Let's do this. He just sprayed Matt in the face with silly string.
This is classic.
That came from 2004, folks.
It looks like we have to look into our history book here, bro.
Yeah, there's going to be a lot of that tonight.
You know a little bit more of the history than I do.
Oh, yeah, that's a Zoo Crew thing, my friends. You want to know, you get on YouTube.
Exactly.
Welcome to the Valley.
And AJ does not look happy.
There's a man sitting in the crowd in a yellow shirt. His name is Frankie Angelini. He's a friend of mine for a long time.
The hardcore legend?
The hardcore legend.
Wow.
He's got some stories about this man, Eric Pinhat, as well.
Oh, my hearts.
Let's get back to this ring, though. AJ Evers is a tight headlock.
But that height advantage from ring crew number two.
Keeps him over.
Had him grounded, almost got a pinfall right away.
That would have been embarrassing for AJ.
It would be.
But maybe, because I don't know if he would catalog it as an embarrassment. I just don't. I don't know if he knows what zip code he's in.
I agree.
I feel like you just heard Eric say, like, AJ's parents are here. I think they had to drive him because I don't think he would know how to get it. Why are there keys? I'm confused. And now there's a frying pan?
Oh!
Was that a frying pan?
Yes, it is, from the Diamond City Hooligan days.
He just chain wrestled with them, and then he hit him with the frying pan.
I recall that frying pan being cracked off my head once before.
What else is in that bag? Is there like a kitchen sink waiting for us somewhere?
Don't you worry about it.
There might be.
Okay, well, you said that scares me.
Paid out a founding member of the Diamond City Hooligans himself. Big J-Skin, Irish Kev, Slick Willie Seaman. They were the precursor of the Diamond City Kings.
Yes.
And is he trying to teach Matt?
He's trying to teach Matt how to grow into the corner.
Oh!
Wow!
That was awesome.
Wait a minute. Is he going to get Matt to try to whip AJ into the opposite corner?
Oh, jeez, not too shabby.
Give it up for Matt now.
Wow.
Okay, that's what? I don't know. How did this happen?
Oh, wait, was it a double whip?
What?
Oh. What's Matt doing? What? I know what this is.
Oh, oh, my God.
How does it feel?
My life is over.
The history book of Pinhat.
Ooh. That sounded fun.
I'm going to apologize to our sound guy, John, for that yelling. Because goddamn, that felt good.
Back rake in motion.
I know that hat. I know that shirt. The Ring Crew shirt comes out, and that hooligan shirt goes on.
The hooligan / Zoo Crew shirt.
Where's Tommy Dreamer and Terry Funk when you need him?
If you also notice Bruno, those are the Diamond City hooligan shorts that he's wearing.
Yep. And that hate breed jersey. He's wrestled for many years as a hooligan on that jersey.
And he is taking it to AJ Evers.
I want to know where they're supposed to go 5 on. That's all I got to say.
Oh, listen, I wish they could be here with us.
I am technically supposed to number 6.
I've heard that.
I do have that. What is AJ doing?
What is going on? Oh, God.
Is he literally doing this?
Be careful. Setting up this air hockey table with two chairs. Oh, man. What is in the bag?
Cheese grater?
What?
Oh, my God.
A ball pit and air hockey table.
Easter eggs.
This goes back to the April.
Oh, no, but AJ, reversing it.
No. Okay.
Pinhat trying to fight out of it.
Pinhat blocking it.
Oh, God.
Good Lord.
Oh, my God.
What just happened?
GSW.
He kicked out at 2.9.
I don't know who's the first of that. Oh my God.
What just happened?
Oh God.
Well, there was an error.
What does Eric Pinhat have to do to end this career of AJ Evers?
Eric pulled out all the tricks tonight.
Wait a minute, he's asking for something from Gladbag.
The cheese grater.
No, okay.
Whoa, I think this goes
back to the BCW days.
Yeah, it does.
Oh, good.
This is. No, please, just. Ah!
He punched him right in the low. He punched him low.
Oh, good Lord.
Is there dollars on his back? Anybody need a dollar?
That's what it seems.
Well, always leave a tip.
All I say is the disgusting looks on parents of AJ Evers is not.
We want to apologize to any parents of him. That was a bit offensive.
Children, look away for a minute.
Did
he just lick it?
He just licked that cheese.
Oh, and he dumps it on the outside. He's not even give the fans the pleasure of seeing the brutality that they thought he would bring.
Thank God.
AJ?
I have a feeling I know what's going on here. Eric asking for him. Come on, bring it on.
Spinning through the Super King. Oh! Super King of his own!
Get on him! Get on him! Eric, come on, buddy!
That knee.
1, 2, 3. Oh,
his hand's on the rope.
He grabbed the rope, I think.
This jerky thing.
The rope is only a 2.
Come on, Eric. You need to end this
right on top of him, buddy. Stay on top of Eric. Do
that
not
is
him.
I feel sick to my stomach right now.
I am shaking here, guys. My nerves are going.
No,
I do not want to see my trainer and good friend.
Buddy,
turn around, Eric.
Oh,
good Lord.
He's not down. He didn't get off on that one.
Eric still got some fight in him.
Now what's he doing? AJ!
Springboard cutter! Oh! Oh my god, all the way across the ring! That was a leap.
3/4 of the way. The Pinhat needs to just roll. Roll, buddy, one!
And on the ropes!
We're on the ropes! Come on, Eric!
Eric Pinhat, foot on the ropes! That springboard stunner has laid out everybody! Oh no.
AJ is not happy about this.
And Pinhat, look, the fire is still there.
Eric is still holding on.
What? Oh! Eric went in for one swing, AJ able to catch him. Oh, able to fight
Eric
out.
Blocked it.
Eric has him up.
The angle slam.
Ever,
oh, God.
Ever slam out of the chairs.
Oh, no. Good Lord, no.
Dude, my last, well, I guess what was supposed to be my last big move, I got dropped on my head on a chair.
Why does everyone keep hitting me in the head? AJ, round, you just can't win.
Wow, buddy, it's okay, it's your
show. You hit me in the head more than anybody.
This is true, I did, actually. It was a hard-fought match, it was a great match, and I had the pleasure of calling it, and I'm very happy to be still standing here with you now. With that being said, no, I did promise the sixth match of this show.
I don't even know what it is.
I don't even know if I want to. I'm kind of waiting on. I guess I have. I did already tease them, didn't I?
Tell them and tell me, because I want to know. You're teasing me too.
All right. It is a fatal four-way. Maybe a fatal five-way, depending on what happens. Let's do this real quick. In that ring, four men. The first one is a returning Shane Storm. Yes. Man number two. Last month, he went toe-to-toe in a losing effort against Kevin Cartwright. That would be the one knowing Jacoby Riddick.
Uh-oh.
These next two men are making their Grand Slam wrestling debuts. And what a show to debut on, like Civil War.
Yeah, man.
The first man, who you may have seen if you do watch Ring of Honor as a rising star, he is Ken Phoenix.
Ken Phoenix.
Yeah, Ken's pretty good. Very good dude. Excellent wrestler. We're set to have him here in GSW.
I think I find him at another match.
Possibility, yeah. And our last fighter in that match, for now, making his debut here as well, is Tony Deppen. Now, Tony Deppen is someone we know very well. Tony Deppen's making a name for himself in this area for the last couple years. Most of the people may have seen him at least like CCW.
Maybe he has a really cool Operation Ivy logo mock-up t-shirt. I actually have one.
Yes, he does. It was like C4 in Canada Smash. We're just happy that Tony finally makes his in-ring GSW debut here at the arena at Civil War. Not only in front of you people at home in the audience here, but also live on powerbomb.tv that night, as again we are streaming live for free on their Facebook page. So again, a couple ways you can join us. $10 ahead. Children, as always, Eric. 12 and under.
12 and under are free. And guess what? I got a secret for you. There's no limit. You can bring as many as you want.
It's a family-friendly good time. The main event might be a little bit harsh for some kids, but you know what? When push comes to shove, lines are drawn to the sand.
Hold on. It's not going to be too violent for kids. They watch the Power Rangers, and guys get boof. They get blown up like crazy. They watch the Ninja Turtles, where guys are swinging swords around like this. There's going to be no swords. Maybe there'll be an explosion, but I doubt it.
I hope not an explosion.
It's going to be family-friendly.
We rep this.
It's going to be hard-hitting, and somebody is going to get their face punched off.
With that being said, for Eric Pinhat, I'm the voice guy, Brad DeMayo. We'll catch you guys next week for an episode of Cybernetic.
It's life's real interesting, you know. It's you got points in your life, and you would think that people want to be sad about them, but that's not where we are. Sometimes people have very close friends pass away, and it's a very somber occasion, but it doesn't have to be, because that's the moment in time when they transcend where we are now to something else, and that's a beginning, it's not an ending. So tonight, Jordan, who I obviously welcomed in, and I would not welcome into the things that I'm doing and trying to explain to the world if I didn't have a very sincere love for him. And now was the time for Jordan to leave. There's only so much you can tell somebody, and there's only so much you can show somebody before they have to go and then experience for themselves. And he did one of the great things that you can do in wrestling, and that's find your home. And the thing that I told him, I don't know if you could hear it when we were in the ring, but I said, you're free, Jordan. Go home. And that's where he's been sent, to his home, his new home, his home that he's never been to before, a home where he's going to make it his own couch and his own coffee table, and he's going to sit there and he's going to look around, and everything that's in there is going to be his. He's no longer renting space. He's living inside himself in his new home. So there's no reason for me to be sad about this. I smile because I know that he's going somewhere better. And maybe the things that I've said to him, maybe the discussions that we've had, maybe the hands that I've put on him have made him, helped him be more who he is. Not who I want him to be, but who he is, and opened him up to bring that in and now to put out where he is. Sometimes I talk about these things and I hope that everyone gets them, but I know, especially when I stand in the middle of the ring and I look around and I am the way that I am and I say the things that I say, and not everybody understands. They're not all on the same page. And the hardest thing about wrestling is being who you are, not denying yourself the opportunity to push who you are out there and let everyone see it, and for them to receive it. Because those people, I mean, you hear it. I know you hear these people who say these names that maybe not everybody wants to hear them say, like my own. But there's a whole other group of people who don't receive. And it's okay. Maybe this isn't for everybody. Maybe the awareness and the freedom that I offer isn't meant for everyone to have. I get that. And when I'm done giving some of myself to everyone else, I sit down, I change like every one of these wrestlers do in the back, and I watch the monitor, and I see the things. I see these teams beating each other, all the brutality, and it's out of hand, and they want to lock it up inside of a cage. But that's not what's most important. Why? Why do they want to take the things that they're doing to such a guttural level that all they want to do is tear the flesh off each other, and they're so out of control that they have to lock it up? That's the thing. That's also the thing that you'll never truly understand about me unless you open yourself up and let me in. The thing is, I say the phrase so many times, the thing is, it's because there's so many things and nobody's listening. Open yourself up. Let me come inside. Because you know that it's not until I come inside that you really get the opportunity to see who I am, to feel what I have to tell you. All I ask is an opportunity. These guys in the cage, they don't want an opportunity. All they need is a time and a place, and they'll tear each other limb from limb every single time. That's all they want to do is they want to bludgeon each other, they want to beat each other, they want to break everything. But why? It's because they're diseased. They have a problem. They're not okay upstairs. They don't know how to open themselves up and to give and to take of everyone and everything and connect. All they want to do is close themselves off from the world and hit it and hit it and hit it. That's why you have two teams of brutal individuals with no leadership. Now you got me. I didn't even try to be a leader. I asked not to be a leader. I didn't go to leadership school. I didn't sit behind a desk and go, this is gonna do this and this is gonna do that. The movement chose me. And I said, okay guys, climb on back. Because you know what? I'm always gonna be right out front. Because that's what a leader does. A leader leads his people into the best opportunities, under the best circumstances. He does not sit behind his people and point and tell them what to do. So if there's anything that you've learned today, I hope you're discussing it amongst yourselves, because I'm not here to tell you what to do. But if you want to follow me, we can go.